Welcome to another video from Master Tutoring. Today we're going to be doing a question from a 2019 Department of Basic Education Mathematics Paper 2 final exam. So our question is from question 5. So it's the first two questions from question 5. So as you can see on the screen, they're based on trigonometry. So before we start solving these questions, just to have something that is going to help you understand what I'm going to be talking about, let us look at the quick revision here. So you must remember from your early trigonometry that tan theta is equals to sine theta over cos theta. Or rather, let us remove this theta and then use x. To drive the point home, so tan x equals to sine x over cos x. This is one thing that you must remember from your early years of trigonometry. If I'm not mistaken, this is from grade 10. So moving along, another thing that you must remember is that sine 2x is the same as 2 sine x cos x. So these are double identities. This is grade 12 work, so you must remember this, and then also remember that cos 2x is the same as cos squared x minus sine squared x. And then let us look at the cos diagram. So the cos diagram looks like this. And then you have 0 degrees here, you have 90, this is a 90 here, you have 180, 270 and 360 there. And then so this is going to be all trigonometric functions, and then this one is only going to be sine, and then this is going to be tan, and then a cos. So this is what we call a cast diagram. Let me just write it here. So the cast diagram, this one. All right. So we know that, okay, in the first quadrant, it's going to be 90 minus theta. This is going to be 180 minus theta, or 90 plus theta. 180 plus theta, 270 minus theta. 270 plus theta, 360 minus theta, and then 360 plus theta. So this is a quick revision of your cos diagram. So all trigonometric functions, they are positive. Only sine is positive here, only cos is positive there, only tan rather is positive, and then here only cos is positive. So now with this information, this should put you in a position to understand these, how we're going to solve these questions here. Without further ado, let us look at the first question. So the first question is given to us as they say, simplify the following expression to one trigonometric term. So this is the expression here. So let us start solving this question. So the numerator here, I'm not going to change it. However, I'm going to change the denominator just a bit. So because we're given tan here, tan x, and then we know that, okay, tan x is the same as sine x over cos x. So we're going to replace this tan x by sine x over cos x. So sine x over cos x. And then we say plus. Now 180 plus. 180 plus is in the third quadrant. Let's check from our cos diagram. You see here's 180 plus. So it's 180 plus in the third quadrant, and we can see that here only tan is positive. So because we have sine 180 plus, it means we're going to change the sign of this sine. So we're going to have negative sine of x because it's in the third quadrant and only tan is positive there. And therefore, 90 minus is in the first quadrant. As you can see here, here's 90 minus. And then all of them are positive. So this, we're not going to change the sign of this. However, because it's a cos, and it's a 90 degrees here, we're going to change this cos into a sine. The reason why we're changing it is because we have to change it to its cofunction. Because it's a cos, it has to become a sine. Therefore, this is going to become sine x. Okay, moving along. So here, we're going to cancel. You see, this cos and that cos is going to cancel. So they're going to divide out. So this cancels with that. And then also, the sine on top and this sine here, they're going to cancel. So this will cancel with that. And then evidently or eventually, we're going to be left with 1. Positive times negative will become a negative. And then sine times sine will become sine squared x. And then we know from trig identities that this 1 minus sine squared x is the same as cos squared x. So this is the answer to this question here. Moving to the second part of the question, it says without using a calculator, determine the value of this expression here. So the first thing that I'm going to do is to copy it down. So we are given sine squared 35x minus 35 degrees rather minus cos squared 35 degrees, and then you divide the whole thing by 4 sine 10 degrees multiplied by cos 10 degrees. So when you look at this numerator here, it actually looks like this trig identity, this one, cos 2x. Rather, let me write it next to this so that I don't have to go back and forth. So we know that I get cos 2x is equals to cos squared x minus sine squared x. So this part here looks similar to this part. Let me highlight it. They look similar. However, as you can see on the diagram, this one, it's sine squared minus, but then this one is cos squared minus sine. So we need to change this to look like that. First of all, you just look at x. In this case, this x, look at it as 35. Or rather, look at this 35 as x. You'll see that, okay, this looks similar. So now to make them look exactly the same, we're going to factor out negative 1 so that cos is positive and then sine is negative, because that's the case in this case. Cos is positive here, sine is negative. So we factor out negative 1. So it's going to be minus cos squared 35 minus sine squared 35 degrees. And then we divide by. Another identity is that if you have sine 2x, this is the same as 2 sine x cos x. So make sure that you also look at this 2. It's a 2, not a 3 or a 4. It's a 2. Let me highlight it. It's not a 3 or a 4. But then in this case, we have 4 sine 10 degrees cos 10 degrees. We're going to factor out positive 2. So 2 sine x cos x. Now this looks similar to that. However, it's not supposed to be an x here. It's supposed to be a 10 degrees. So I just wanted to help you see how they are related. So we're going to replace this x by 10 degrees. Replace this by 10 degrees. Then 10. Okay. So this is going to be the same as, now we're going to replace this by cos 2 times 35 degrees. So this is going to be cos 2 times 35 degrees, like that. And then 2 over sine, replacing the denominator, this part, by sine 2 times 10 degrees. 2 times 10 degrees. And then this becomes minus cos 70 degrees over 2 sine 20 degrees. 70 degrees can be written as 90 minus 20. So we are deliberately choosing 20 degrees because we want to make the numerator to look exactly the same as this denominator so that they can cancel. So 90 minus 20 is 70, and then we divide by 2 sine 20 degrees. And then, so 90 minus, again, this is in the first quadrant, and we know that all trigonometric functions in the first quadrant are positive. So this will become, will not change, the sign is not going to change. However, we're going to change this cos into a sine because it's a 90 degrees, so it has to change to its cofunction. So therefore, we're going to have sine 20 degrees over 2 sine 20 degrees. And then this will cancel with that. And then eventually, we have minus 1 over 2. So that is the answer to this question. So we've solved, actually, we solved this into that, into negative half, without using a calculator. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've learned something from this. And if you want to see more questions similar to this one, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and then you hit the bell notification so that you get updated whenever I upload videos similar to these ones. And for new viewers, I hope you like this. And then if you have questions that you'd want us to help you with, please make sure that you leave a comment here. And then good luck, you guys, with everything, with your math, the exams and everything. Goodbye.